Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 22nd of December. Indian government issues new SOPs for those arriving from UK in view of new COVID strain. Baloch activist found dead in Canada under mysterious circumstances. An Afghanistan journalist killed near his home in Ghazni province. And now for all the details. The Indian government on Tuesday issued fresh standard operating procedure for passengers arriving from UK amid fears of fast spread of a new and highly infectious COVID-19 strain in Britain. The country's civil aviation ministry has already ordered suspension of UK-originated flights from Wednesday.
India's health ministry on Tuesday released new standard operating procedures or SOPs citing the new strain of coronavirus being detected in the United Kingdom. The ministry said SOPs are now required to be followed at all entry points into the country and within the community with regard to air passengers who have travelled or transited through the UK in the past 4 weeks, starting from November 25 to December 23. This comes as at least 5 people arriving in India from Britain tested positive for the novel coronavirus on Tuesday. But it was not clear if they had a highly infectious new strain of the virus.
Data bhi bata raha hai ki ab jaise London mein England ke andar 5-7000 cases aate the ab 30000 se zyada per day cases aa rahe hain to ekdam se kafi zyada spread wahan par aaya hai aur isi wajah se kal humne request ki thi kendra sarkar ko ki bhai UK se aane wali sari flights ko band kiya jaye.
Meanwhile, India is gearing up to facilitate transportation of the coronavirus vaccine with GMR Hyderabad Air Cargo, among others, making necessary arrangements for the distribution of the vaccine. Expressing confidence in the working of Project Sanjeevani, which is related to handling and redistribution of coronavirus vaccines, a senior official said that both cargo terminals of the Delhi airport are equipped with cool chambers to handle the vaccines. India is making robust supply chain arrangements to ensure that the doses of the coronavirus vaccine reach its 1.3 billion people. The country on Tuesday recorded 19,556 new COVID-19 cases, the lowest in 6 months, according to data from the Health Ministry.
Farmer leaders on Tuesday continued to press for rollback of 3 new farm laws that liberalise agriculture sector, while the Indian government appealed the protesting farmers to hold further talks to break a nearly month-long deadlock. Farmers on Tuesday blocked Delhi's Ghazipur border with Uttar Pradesh as the protest entered 27th day.
Farmers' leaders on Tuesday continued to press for a repeal of 3 new agricultural reforms, while the Indian government appealed the protesting farmers to hold further talks to break a nearly month-long deadlock. A relay hunger strike continued on Tuesday for the second day at the Indian capital New Delhi's borders with Haryana and Uttar Pradesh states, where the protesting farmers have been camping for more than 3 weeks. Representatives of farmers claimed the centre government in its latest letter has said it wants to hold talks over its earlier proposal of amendments, but they see complete rollback of the laws which aim to liberalise the agriculture sector.
यही पर टूटी थी कि हमें अमेंडमेंट मंजूर नहीं है, आप कृषि के 3 कानून वापस ले लीजिए, तो बात जहां टूटी थी वहां पर ही खड़ी है।
Meanwhile, farmers blocked Delhi's Ghazipur border with Uttar Pradesh state on Tuesday, which affected movement of traffic as both sides' carriageways were closed. Farmer leaders were expected to meet later in the day to discuss further plan of action to press for their demands.
In news from Pakistan, the Pakistan Democratic Movement and 11-party alliance will begin on Wednesday the second phase of anti-government protests to oust the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government led by Prime Minister Imran Khan by January 31. Ahead of the protest, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari said that Khan was ignorant of the ground realities and did not have any solution of the problems the people are faced with. Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari on Monday lashed out at the Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government for being unaware of ground realities while calling for the Premier to resign if he cannot provide solutions to the issues faced by the public. Cornering Imran Khan, the opposition leader said that the puppet Premier could not give an answer as to what he was doing for the public, which was enough evidence for him to resign.
This is enough evidence ke hamara wazir azam agar uske paas awam ka masail kam karne ka hal nahi hai agar awam ka awam pe jo bojh gair zaruri bojh is waqt dal raha hai usko kam karne ka uske paas solutions nahi hai to wazir azam ko istifa dena chahiye pakistan people's party ke paas hamare paas awam ko relief dene ke solutions hai.
Earlier this month, opposition 11-party Alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement (PDM) demanded the Khan's government to quit by January 31 or face intensified movements by opposition parties such as the Long March to Islamabad. Meanwhile, PDM will begin on Wednesday the second phase of anti-government protests to oust the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government by January 31. The second phase of movement will start with a public meeting in Mardan on December 23. Moving on, activist Karima Baloch, who was known for being a vocal critic of the Pakistan Army and government atrocities in Balochistan, has been found dead under mysterious circumstances in Canada. Human rights activists have blamed role of Pakistan's spy agencies in her death, while highlighting constant fear under which dissidents and critics of the Pakistani establishment live for raising their voices.
Karima Baloch, an activist who had been vocal about Pakistan Army and government atrocities in Balochistan, has been found dead in Canada's Toronto city. Karima, a refugee in Canada, had gone missing on Sunday, and Toronto police had requested for public assistance in locating her. However, now her family has confirmed that her body has been found, according to media reports. The cause of her death was, however, not clear. Karima Baloch was known for raising the issue of ongoing human rights violations in Balochistan and blamed Pakistan of exploiting natural resources and eliminating the dissenting voices in the region at international forums, including the UN.
It is a matter of grave concerns for us that Baloch activists who are not safe in Balochistan and to raise their voice if they leave the country, the ISI goons, their assassins, their target killers, they chase us.
The dissidents and critics of the Pakistani authorities live under constant fear, as the criticism of the military in Pakistan has always been frowned upon. Scores of Baloch activists, in order to avoid persecution, are compelled to seek asylum in Western countries.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. A member of the peace negotiating team representing Afghan government in the peace talks with the Taliban, Fawzia Kufi, has said an explanation by the Republic about the agenda of the talks is essential before entering into the second round of negotiations with the Taliban. The remarks come as the Afghan government's team is in capital Kabul for consultations amid halt in Doha talks.
Fawzia Kufi, a member of the peace negotiating team representing Afghan government in the talks with the Taliban, has said an explanation by the Republic about the agenda of the talks is essential before entering into the second round of negotiations with the Taliban. The remark comes as the Afghan government's team is in capital Kabul for consultations amid halt in Doha talks. The lack of a political consensus in the peace process and the lack of explanation from Afghan government's team about the agenda of the talks for the second round are key challenges on the way of Republic's team. Experts believe that the mentioned challenges can delay the second round of talks. Meanwhile, the High Council of National Reconciliation in Afghanistan is expected to convene its leadership committee meeting in the next few days, in which the committee will give its directives to the Republic team about the agenda of the talks in the second round. As of now, both sides of the Afghan peace negotiations, the Afghan government and the Taliban, agree to resume talks on January 5.
More news from Afghanistan. Freelance journalist and chairman of Provincial Journalist Association Rahmatullah Niksad was shot by unknown assailants near his house in provincial capital Ghazni city on Monday evening. Reports suggest the journalist working for several foreign media outlets is the fifth journalist to have been killed in the last 2 months in Afghanistan. Afghanistan journalist Rahmatullah Niksad, also the head of Journalist Union in Ghazni province, was killed in an armed attack on Monday evening. Reports suggest the journalist working for Associated Press and Al Jazeera is the fifth journalist to have been killed in the last 2 months in Afghanistan. During his career, Niksad was arrested at various times by the United States, the Afghan government and Taliban insurgents. Condemning the incident, Reporters Without Borders said in a tweet, "This is the third targeted murder of an Afghan journal within 6 weeks. RSF calls on the UN to take concrete measures to protect journalists." The Taliban has denied its involvement in Monday's attack. Since November 7, several journalists have been killed in different incidents. Amid an increase of threats against media workers in Afghanistan, journalists recently called on the government to launch an investigation into recent attacks that killed several journalists in the country. They say that lack of attention to the investigation of attacks against media workers will cause severe harm to press freedom in the country. Moving on, High Commissioner of Sri Lanka to Pakistan visited Navy headquarters in Islamabad and called on Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Mohammad Amjad Khan on Monday. Both the dignitaries discussed matters related to mutual interest, regional security and bilateral collaborations.
Sri Lankan High Commissioner to Pakistan retired Vice Admiral Mohan Vijay Vikrama on Monday called on Pakistan Navy Chief Admiral Amjad Niazi at the Naval Headquarters in Islamabad. According to Pakistan Navy's Directorate General Public Relations, the two sides discussed matters of mutual interest, regional security, and promotion of bilateral cooperation in maritime domain. Last week, the sixth round of Foreign Secretary-level bilateral political consultations, BPC, between Pakistan and Sri Lanka was held virtually. Both sides discussed the whole gamut of bilateral relations, including cooperation in the political, economic, defense, trade and investment, culture and education fields, as well as people-to-people exchanges. There was convergence on both sides for strengthening existing mechanisms of cooperation and exploring new avenues of bilateral collaboration.
Scores of winter sport lovers have been thronging India's cold desert region of Ladakh for skating and playing hockey on frozen water bodies. Ice hockey is a sport that is fast gaining popularity in India, especially Ladakh, where sub-zero temperatures cause water bodies to freeze.
Hundreds of winter sport lovers thronged Leh, the capital of India's federal territory of Ladakh, for skating and playing hockey on frozen water bodies this past weekend. Every year, as temperature dips during the winters, the water freezes into ice, which provides a favorable space for winter sports and other activities in Ladakh.
हमे ice hockey खेलने के लिए मिलता है. ये बहुत natural है यहाँ. पानी जम जाता है, फिर हम उसी पर ही ice skate खेलते हैं. वरना बाकियों में तो हम machine से ice skate बनाते हैं. बहुत मुश्किल होती है. लेकिन यहाँ पर ये ice skate बहुत natural है, तो हमें वो बहुत फायदा होता है.
Ice hockey is a sport that is gaining popularity in India in places mostly like Ladakh, Kashmir Valley and Shimla, where sub-zero temperatures cause water bodies to freeze. Much of India has a tropical climate, hence ice sports are limited to the few artificial rinks available.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.